Game 7. The two greatest words in sports.
Right now, it's not about what's left in the tank.
It's what you've got in your heart.
When your backs are against the wall, you play your best game.
You can run for a long time. Sooner or later, they'll cut you down.
Nothing is guaranteed.
The hardest win is to get the fourth one and close a team out.
I don't think it matters how you win at this point in this season.
Playing at home in front of your fans, Game 7, where would you rather be?
In this game, your resolve is tested. Your body is pushed to its limits.
We still got another level to get to.
The soul of a team is revealed.
Game 7. Win and move on?
It's that simple. And that complicated.
You're watching the Stanley Cup Playoffs on ESPN, presented by GEICO. The Rangers and Devils have been Hudson River rivals for 40 years now. But tonight they meet for just the third time in a Game 7, for the first time since 1994, and for the first time ever here in New Jersey. The Rangers forced this Game 7 two nights ago by staving off elimination for the sixth time in the last two postseasons. Now both teams are looking the end of the season squarely in the eye as they take the ice tonight here in Newark. Good evening, everybody, and welcome. I'm Sean McDonough along with Ray Ferraro. Delighted to have you with us. Ray, two nights ago when we came on the air in MSG, you talked about how if the New York Rangers were going to extend their season, they needed much more from their top scorers, and they got it. Tonight, it's the Devils who certainly are looking for a lot more from some of their key performers up front.
It's remarkable through six games of this series how many times we've seen capable, quality performers not be able to get on the board. The Rangers needed something from Chris Kreider, who went quiet in games 4 and 5, and Mika Zibanejad, who had a real silent first 5 games of the series. Well, they got it. Kreider was fantastic in game 6. Zibanejad played his best game of the series. Now they hope in game 7 to untrack Patrick Kane. This was emblematic of the way his game 6 went. A missed shot, a frustrated star. The Devils, on the other hand, to get to game 6, and they've had no offense from outside of Jack Hughes, the top end of their roster. Nico Hischier has not had anything going for him. Timo Meier has 26 shots. Brat had 30-plus goals in the season. They need somebody to step up and score a goal. It's been a remarkably tight series, in particular 5-on-5. One of those four, maybe Panarin, maybe King, punches through in Game 7.
Well, if you're a Devils fan, you have to think one of those four is due to score tonight, 123 combined goals in the regular season. The Rangers feel their playoff experience is an edge. The Devils hoping it's home ice. One place where the Rangers definitely think they have the advantage is in the goal. Igor Shesterkin now 22 straight playoff games allowing 3 goals or fewer. We didn't know earlier today who the goalie would be for the New Jersey Devils. It's Akira Schmidt.
Well, and I think it's the right decision for Lindy Ruff and his coaching staff. They went to Akira Schmidt in game 3, down 2-0. It was a bold move at the time, and really he's done nothing to lose the net. He had a speed bump in game 6 and gave up the 5 goals before he was yanked with about 7 minutes left. He needs to bounce back in a big spot here. Igor Shesterkin's been nothing but brilliant for the Rangers over the last couple of seasons. In this series, far and away, the Rangers' best player. It's an edge in goal for the Rangers, but game 7, toss it up. Who knows?
They are indeed two of the greatest words in sports. Game 7. And the opening faceoff comes your way in moments from Newark.
Win and move on. It's that simple. Game 7.
Yeah. Back in our ESPN studios, you might recall prior to Game 3, Mr. New Jersey Devil,
Paulo Greed,
P.K. Subban graced us.
The Nature Boy.
With this particular wardrobe choice.
Sexiest man
But now, as we get ready for Game 7 tonight, the Rangers and the Devils, we introduce you.
Are you kidding me?
To the captain, Mark Messier.
Let's go, Rangers!
Is there any doubt we are ready for Game 7 to New Jersey? Sean McDonough.
All right, gentlemen, thank you. And here inside Prudential Center, let's join public address announcer Adam Hamway.
Remove your hats as the New Jersey Department of Corrections Honor Guard presents tonight's colors. And join in the singing of our national anthem, performed tonight by organist Pete Canarosi and Arlette.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, came that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
The Rock is rocking Game 7, the final game of the first round of these NHL playoffs. And the crowd fired up by Devils legend Martin Brodeur. They're hoping their starting goalie tonight can perform like he did for so many years in the net. For New York, it's Igor Shesterkin. A 179 goals against in this series and a 930 save percentage. Playing in his third game seven of his career. 2-0 against Pittsburgh and Carolina last year. Akira Schmidt, 1.72 goals against, is better than Igor Shesterkin's 179. Just the one hiccup, and Lindy Ruff felt most of those goals the other night of the five he allowed were really not his fault. Starting lineups are brought to you by GoDaddy.